Picture this. You're a supervillain and your latest heist has left your pockets overflowing with cash. You might be wondering what to do with your ill-gotten gains and looking to invest in some serious firepower to add to your sinister arsenal. So why not invest in a tank? But you aren't interested in some rusty old relic. Something fresh and expensive is much more your style. That's where the K2 Black Panther, the most expensive tank in the world, comes in. Not to be confused with the Marvel superhero of a similar name, the K2 Black Panther was first introduced into service in 2014 as part of the military of South Korea and costs a staggering $8.5 million US. And that's not for all the South Korean military's K2 Black Panthers. That's like $8.5 million per tank. So what sets the K2 apart from other tanks, and what makes this tank the most expensive tank on the market? Designed between 1995 and 2008 by South Korea's Agency for Defense Development, or ADD, the K2 is manufactured by Hyundai Rotem, a South Korean company specializing in the manufacture of defense products that also happens to be, you guessed it, a part of the Hyundai Motor Group. That's right, if you own an Elantra or a Sonata, then there's a link between your car and the world's most expensive tank. Although if you were to drive a K2 down the street, you definitely wouldn't get stuck in traffic or cut off by other drivers. After all, yours is the only vehicle on the road that weighs 61 tons, and that's about the same as 10 African elephants. It could roll over and crush the average car like a tin can. One of the key reasons for the K2's development and introduction was to serve as a viable replacement for the remainder of South Korea's M48 patent tanks. Why? Well, for one, the M48 is a much older tank, first introduced almost 70 years ago in 1951. While a great number of these older model tanks were phased out in the US during the mid-90s, it was around this time that the South Korean Agency for Defense Development began designing what would eventually become the K2 Black Panther. So what makes the K2 superior and a suitable replacement for all the M48s that were eventually decommissioned, moved to storage, and ultimately phased out of use? The K2 Black Panther is what is commonly known as a next-generation tank. While that's a term that you may have heard attributed to technology like cell phones or gaming consoles, a next-generation or fourth-generation tank is a model that incorporates technology to propel it to a completely new generation of weaponry. Remember the M48s we mentioned before? Well, those are first-gen tanks. The M48 patent tanks were among several variations introduced immediately after the Second World War. On the other hand, the K2, along with other fourth-generation tanks, are better equipped to deal with the requirements of contemporary-era warfare, thanks to its modern design, technology, and weaponry. Now, you may be wondering, what about the K2 justifies its $8.5 million price tag? After all, for the same price, you could buy two Bugatti Chiron Supersports, the fastest car in the world, and still have 700 grand left over for around 630 iPhone 11 Pro Maxes. Well, perhaps you might be tempted by some of the truly unique features the K2 Black Panther is said to offer. But we don't mean heated seats or self-parking, we're talking weaponry. After all, you're looking for a tank that can make a statement, and nothing says firepower like a state-of-the-art 120mm smoothbore gun capable of firing unique KSTAM ammunition. But what the heck is KSTAM, you may be asking? KSTAM stands for Korean Smart Top Attack Munition. You see, what sets the K2 apart from other previous and current generation tanks is that it's the only tank in the world to use KSTAM ammunition. That's because this type of munition was developed specifically for the K2 Black Panther. So what's so special about KSTAM? Well, something you need to understand about a lot of modern tanks is that they're designed to be deployed against other tanks, which are usually not only heavily armored targets but also far away. The K2's KSTAM ammo overcomes these problems, as it's designed to directly target the very top of an enemy's tank turret. Why? This is because a great number of older generation tanks, and even many newer ones, are much more vulnerable directly on top of their turrets, where their armor is the thinnest. The KSTAM is designed to be fired from the K2's 120mm gun, and is equipped with its own self-guiding navigation system. That's what's commonly known as a fire and forget, as you can launch one of these projectiles from a safe distance, and then it does the work for you. This means that the K2 can fire while completely hidden from the view of an enemy tank, just as long as there's ample room for the tank to elevate that big 120mm gun barrel. Once fired, the KSTAM travels toward its target or can be directed by a live data link feed at a minimum range of 2 kilometers and a maximum of 8 kilometers. That's between 21 and 87 football fields long. Upon reaching the designated target area, a KSTAM then deploys a parachute as it begins its descent on an unsuspecting enemy tank. allowing the projectile's infrared and target acquisition sensors to spot whoever's about to need one pretty big umbrella. All the while, you're at a safe distance, nice and cozy in your K2 and already getting into a good book as the KSTAM you fired makes light work of the other tank. To summarize, you could park this tank around the corner and still hit someone 8 kilometers away in the next town over. Sure, that's worth $8.5 million, right? That's almost $1 million for every kilometer. Okay, so having its own unique ammunition might be one selling point of the K2 Black Panther, but if it can dish out some long-distance damage, how much can it withstand? After all, the last thing you want is for your new K2 to get dented before you can drive it off the lot. Luckily, the K2 is a well-protected machine, sporting a classified type of composite armor. While the exact materials aren't available or known to the public, we do know that the term composite armor refers to layers of various material, most commonly either metals, plastics, or ceramics, or a combination of these. This is done to give the vehicle's armor more resistance against oncoming fire while also keeping the armor itself lightweight. Of course, this is a costly method of protecting a vehicle, which contributes to the expensive overall price of the K2, but at least it'll keep out any troublesome high-explosive anti-tank or heat ordnance. In fact, it's claimed that the frontal armor of the K2 is capable of withstanding fire from other tanks with similar 120mm armaments as the K2 itself. On top of composite armor, the K2 Black Panther also makes use of ERA blocks. In this context, ERA stands for Explosive Reactive Armor, and this is designed to offer further protection against chemical energy warheads. ERA commonly consists of a sandwich formed of a slab of high explosive between two metal plates. It's not the kind you want to have for lunch. Now, having a high explosive inside your K2 tank armor might sound risky, but this actually offers a counter explosion to any incoming warheads. The primary purpose of all anti-tank weaponry is for the ammunition to pierce the outer armor and either kill or injure the crew inside the tank, or damage the vehicle's inner mechanical systems, if not both of these. ERA combats this by having a layer of high explosive detonate upon impact of an incoming projectile, the force of the counter explosion driving the projectile away from the K2 tank and keeping the occupants safe. So we've looked at firepower, ammo, and defenses, and all that contributes to making the K2 the pricey tank that it is. But before you purchase one, you still need to know things like, well, how well does it move across different types of terrain? What's the K2's top speed? And how many of your evil henchmen will you need to help you operate the tank? The first batch of South Korea's K2 Black Panther tanks, 100 of which were created between 2014 and 2015, all featured an MTU MT883 KA501 engine. This was then replaced with an engine known as the Doosan DV27K. For both the second batch of 106 tanks built between 2019 and 2020 and the third batch, which are still in production as of March 2020, and consists of 54 tanks. This allows the K2 to accelerate from 0 to 20 miles per hour or 0 to 32 kilometers per hour in only 7 seconds. When traveling off-road, the K2 can reach speeds of up to 31 miles per hour or 50 kilometers per hour, which is about the same as a normal car moving at typical speed through a busy city or a residential area. On paved roads, the K2's maximum speed peaks at an even higher 43 miles per hour or 70 kilometers per hour, which is almost the same speed as a car driving reasonably fast down a highway. While this might not seem like much in comparison to the speed of an average car, it's important to remember that cars don't weigh over 60 tons and aren't fitted with armor designed to stop incoming projectiles or a huge KSTAM firing gun on top. While the K2 Black Panther's speed really measures up against other tanks. For example, the United States Marine Corps' M1 Abrams tank can only move at 40 kilometers per hour when traveling off-road, a full 10 kilometers an hour slower than the speed of a K2 moving across the same terrain. Additionally, the British Army's Challenger 2 tank can only reach a speed of 37 miles per hour on open road, while the K2 can leave it in the dust, moving 6 miles per hour faster. So far, we've looked into the offensive and defensive capabilities of the K2 Black Panther, as well as its top speeds and effectiveness both on and off roads. But how many will be cramping up the inside of your K2 tank and leaving half-eaten candy bars in the glove box? Fortunately, not that many. Including you, the K2 only needs a crew of 3 to operate it. One commander, one gunner, and one driver. The gunner's role is, as the title suggests, to operate the massive 120mm gun turret. Luckily for whoever's job that is, the main gun features an auto-loader, negating the need for an additional 4th crew member like some other tanks, such as the M1 Abrams or Challenger 2 that we mentioned earlier. So an advantage the K2 gunner has is that the main gun is loaded automatically and everyone benefits from one less crew member taking up space inside. On top of that, the commander of a K2 can take over control of the main gun from the gunner, and in the event of emergency, the K2 can be operated by as little as one person, thanks to that fire and forget KSTAM ammo. Just remember, if you're taking your K2 out for a spin on your own, don't try to multitask by driving and firing at the same time. In summary, its advanced armor, weapons, speed capabilities, and need for minimal crew are what make the K2 Black Panther the world's most expensive tank. So, are you ready to get your own and continue your villainous reign of terror? Well, sadly, you can't, as civilians can only purchase military tanks that have been decommissioned, meaning all weapons and firing systems have to be deactivated. On top of that, you need a special permit to drive one in public, and rubberized treads to avoid damaging the road. So if you had your heart set on owning a K2 tank for global domination, it's probably better to give your $8.5 million back to whoever you stole it from and turn yourself over to the police. We hope you enjoyed this episode of the Infographics Show. If you did, then be sure to check out our videos on the top 10 most powerful tanks and 50 insane tank facts that will shock you. Thanks for watching. Okay, we'll see ourselves out.